Hey, so this is just a quick video I put together in case you happen to be someone who is lucky enough to have been asked to help take care of the animals here in our house, the majority of which involves taking care of our cats. The dog has to be taken out for walks periodically, but other than that, the dog actually eats the same food and water as the cats. There are three components to what needs to be done to take care of the cats. You have to clean the cat litter, you have to make sure their food is topped off, and then you have to make sure that their water is clean and fresh. So, we'll start with the cat litter first. You can either use a garbage bag, or we have smaller office size trash can liners that are good for scooping the poop out of their cat litter box into. So, right here in the kitchen, in this corner, we've got a variety of containers for that sort of thing. These work great. Right there, trash can liners. And voila. Next, we move on to the utility room, which is where all of this, or the laundry room, which is where all this stuff fits. So coming into here, we have the water and the food bowl right there. And then further on, we have the cat litter. So I will pull the cat litter box out and show you how we go about scooping it. Apologies for the weird camera angle, but I just wanted to kind of make sure. I was more interested in function over form. So basically, we pull the cat litter box out. Here's a handy dandy scoop that we use. And you just take the bag like so. And all you're really doing is scraping through this stuff and getting all the stuff out. So you just scoop and sift, right? Scoop, sift, and then dump. Sometimes when they pee, they make these gigantic big clods of or clumps of stuff. Make sure that you get all that. You really want to scrape. After you get all the loose stuff, you want to scrape the bottom, because you'll see like where it gets wet sometimes like this. You just want to make sure that you're getting all of that out. Because what happens, the cats are pretty good, but I don't know, I guess on occasion they can get finicky and get tired of pooping on top of poop. So they'll actually go somewhere else. They'll sometimes use the carpet or something like that if they're sufficiently miffed. So like when you get down to this point, you've gotten most of the loose stuff. You just want to kind of scrape like this and go back and forth from all the sides towards the middle. Making sure you haven't missed anything, and then when you're done, just kind of smooth it all down and give them a nice fresh bed, and you're all done. Just slide it back in, put the scooper away, take the bag, tie it up, and take it out to the trash can. We don't like to leave it in the house. Beyond that, all we really have is, like I said before, the food and the water. So, the water bowl, you just want to get down in there and make sure that it's clean. They normally drink from this part where the water runs out at the top, so, but it's just a good indicator if it still is fresh. And then make sure that the food bowl is topped off. The food container is here. It's got a little scoop. You just scoop it in. Too easy. Oh, and probably the final unsaid part of the task that I didn't really mention, but I, you know, it's just a nice thing is if you, like a lot of times the animals will knock food out like this, you know. So if you wanted to just grab a broom and sweep it up, you can put that in the trash or whatever, and that just helps keep it neat in the laundry room. And that's it. Nothing to it. I appreciate you guys helping us out and taking care of our animals, and I know they do too. And thanks.